G'day, I'm Callum Johns, and welcome to a review of the Battle Angel Alita manga. I'm going to begin by saying that I actually read these digitally first, and then I bought the really nice hardcover box set of them. So I've actually read this twice through to give some really nice thoughts on it. I won't go in depth like my Star Wars Expanded Universe reviews as much, because I just sat down, read these and enjoyed them. I'll more go into what they sort of overall thoughts and some really cool bits and pieces. So what I want to start by doing is by making them fall out. But this is actually the first manga that I've ever bought, which is really cool because my story with this is I watched the Alita Battle Angel movie and I was interested in seeing what else there was on it because I really enjoyed it. And so I watched the OVA, which was actually quite good as well. I enjoyed that. It was interesting to see the different type of story than what James Cameron and Robert Rodriguez had done with Alita Battle Angel. And then that led inevitably to reading the manga, because there is no other form of the story continuation and I wanted to read more of it. Here we got, I'll just show these, we got volume 1. Something I really love about these is the art style as well. And something really cool, which I didn't read in my first read through when I downloaded it digitally, is that the first few pages of the Deluxe Edition are actually in colour, which I think is really cool and I really enjoyed that. So what's really different as well about this is that it delves into a really unique cyberpunk world, which I really enjoy. The plot and the ideas used in it are brilliant and I really enjoy it. It also offers a very, like, of course these were released earlier, but very much a cyberpunk from the 80s or 90s type feel. And of course Yukito Kishiro, who wrote these and drew them, multi-talented, rather than comic books you get it where it's like someone else draw it and someone else wrote it. No, he did all of it, but it's really cool. The genre and tone are very unique as well, is that because of the way that it is, it gives a very cyberpunk sort of feel to it, but it's a lot more visceral and dirty world than we see in the Alita Battle Angel movie, which I thought was very interesting, and we get a lot more blood and gore and a lot more messed up crap, basically. Of course, there's still the opportunity to do that. But it was funny after reading this as well. Fun story. I read these. It goes from right to left, of course. Ooh, beautiful art. Yeah, love the art in it. Love the art. But something I noticed when I went back to reading comic books is like I started reading from right to left, which is funny. But anyway, the dialogue I find it's quite interesting. Noticing between the two versions, I read the original version that I downloaded digitally, and then I read these ones, and they have retranslated it for the deluxe edition. And so I noticed some bits of dialogue were different, but they also still kept the feel of the series to it, which is actually really good, and I think they did a good job of it. Some maybe not as memeable in the new version, but it gets the meaning across. And just really love the pacing of this. It's like, here's some quiet moments to let build character and a heap of awesome action as well. And there's a lot more character building later on in the future series as well that I noticed. But yeah, we got volume 1. Make sure I do this properly. Got volume 2, which obviously is the Motorball, as you can see from the image, which they translated to the Alita Battle Angel movie, and it's actually really cool. They didn't have that in the first one because they only told volume 1 in the OVA, in the first movie I should say, which is actually really cool. And I think the visuals, of course, the art's great. I really love the art, and you see throughout the series as well. I already showed off some of the art, but like even just the art on the covers is great. I love it. He's self-taught, which is very interesting, and it gives a really good view of how he's grown as an artist as well when you start reading the newest ones, because like, this is the original series, and then there is Battle Angel Alita Last Order, and then there's the current series, Battle Angel Alita Mars Chronicle, which is actually really cool. Well, I love how it continues the story in this as well, and it's really interesting how much depth it gives to the characters, and like each of the characters that are introduced are given a depth that is really good. I mean, some of them are nameless ones, but yeah, but even then they get stories and explaining who they are, and especially like with some of the things that you see. What have I got here? You've even got Chaos, which is a great character, and it really is interesting how it seems on the surface quite different how Destiny Nova is in this series to the adaptation in the James Cameron movie, James Cameron Robert Rodriguez, the live action movie. But it's interesting to see what they would do if they would do a sequel for Alita Battle Angel, which I want to happen because I want to see what they do. Of course, it's not the same story because they changed things, but they kept the core of the characters and the respect and the main meaning behind the story accurate, which is actually really good. I think that James Cameron was able to keep that together. So you get to the end of it with Volume 5, and what I thought was interesting about this was that it has an ending that in the original version isn't, like, Yukito Kishiro had some issues and he had to finish the series short, and so he created a different ending that was more poetic than in the original, in the carried on version, when he decanonized the ending of this and continued the series on when he felt better, which I think is really interesting how that plays out and how it ties in together still with okay, so I have a page here, I didn't have this in the original one, but it explains that the following pages are another vision of Battle Angel Alita published after this ending but before Last Order. It is really cool how they have a whole canonical thing that they kept the continuity in line when he wanted to create more, rather than just saying, oh, well, I'm gonna write my thing and not explain it at all. But yeah. So yeah, this is why Kodansha Comics as well that published these, and I really love them, and I've grown to love the world of Battle Angel Alita, which is really cool, and I can't fault this at any point, other than maybe the ending. There's a lot of scientific grounding in this as well, like all of the technology is based on real science and theoretical science and things that are theories now but could be possibilities later and everything with nanomachines and all that good stuff. So I find it really interesting how he integrates that into the world of cyborgs and the cyberpunk world where everything is going awesome. Yeah. Everything is actually not going awesome, but everything is actually progressed in a way that is dark and gritty in the end, but also gives the notes of hope. And the way when I read it is like, especially when it develops it more in the later series, there's a lot of what humanity has done that is wrong and has caused the future to be not as good, but then also we have Alita being light in the darkness and everything. Yeah. Also add in that there's a short round of series, this says, featuring the multiple spin-off Ash and Victor. So Yukito Kishiro wrote some stories in between this and the newer series, which was him trying to get back into drawing manga and getting his head in the right place and whatever. It explains it really well in Just So Happens This, which is included in the deluxe edition box set which is Holy Night and Other Stories. And it's really cool because in the fun, it just so happens, it clears up the chronology as of Phase 58 of Last Order. So it's actually got a clear chronology to it, which I really like, how it's kept it in continuity and everything. But also what's really cool about these is that adds background to Daisuke Ito's clinic, repair clinic, and a bunch of other things and just little stories that add to the universe, which are great. I think they're great anyway. I really enjoyed Alita and reading this. I'm in love with Alita. Woo. I really love the story and the way that it's progressing. And what I love as well is the whole theme of, it's a big cyberpunk theme around the time this came out, of course, but the whole theme of what makes us human. And it's delved into even more in the later series, which is awesome. Also highlight, there are these awesome prints in the deluxe edition box set when I bought it. So, it's really awesome. Because the art's great, and I got the prints for it. It's awesome. But yeah, if you liked the movie, Alita Battle Angel, I think it is a different take on it because, of course, with how we view science fiction now, it's very much things are more clean and clinical and taken to making things seem more futuristic to us. But of course, this has some more clunky feel in the manga with the bit more boxy technology and some things that are like, this is how the future was envisioned back in the 80s, 90s sort of thing. Which I think is really cool because you get some really interesting types of technology there as well. But yeah, definitely check this out if you like the movie. And the OVA is quite good as well. That's an anime movie version of the first volume of the manga. And then we don't have an actual anime series for it either, which I'd love an anime series for Battle Angel Alita because then it'll be more accessible for people to know the story as well. But yeah, I really love it. Got great art, all that good stuff. And it really gives you a great cyberpunk world to get into, which I've grown to love and get into really well because it's like, it takes you through a whole journey of rollercoaster emotional rides and great things happen. And then the villain is sort of the villain, but then also sort of helps in some ways, and then it's still the villain. But it also questions a lot of morality things and what's going on and everything. It's really cool. And oh, the action in it. The action is great. As the art is great as well. You see the action in it and you go, well, yeah, just awesomeness. And a lot is based on Panzer Kunst, of course. If you watch the movie, that's the martial arts style that Alita uses. And then there's a whole backstory to that, which is built upon, of course, again, in the series, which is really cool. But yeah, I didn't want to spoil anything for anyone, so I'm keeping this fairly vague for details, but I just really like the world that Battle Angel Alita brings, and you can immerse yourself in and escape into. I really love it. So yeah, if you've read this, let me know what you think. I definitely recommend it, and if you want to do like I did, you can read it digitally first, and then you can read the overall manga of it. No, you can buy it to support it because we want more Alita. And I'm also looking forward to Mars Chronicle Volume 7 coming out in April, which will be really cool. But for now, a couple of the arts on the box are really nice. That would be one of my favourite panels from it. And then there's another one here, which is really cool. So yeah, if you've read it, let me know what you think. I'd love to chat about it. And if you didn't know about it, you just heard about it, and interested in reading it, let me know. Because I'd love to just hear about people getting into the world and universe. It's great, and it's great fun, and I really enjoy reading it. I love it so much. When I love something, I get a bunch of stuff for it. But I love it so much. I just read through these and just smashed it over the summer break, summer here, the Christmas break, because Christmas is summer down here in Australia. So yeah, let me know your things. Really cool world, definitely recommend. And so thank you guys so much for watching this. I hope you enjoyed hearing my thoughts on the Battle Angel Alita manga. And I'll see you in the next video. Uru!